Hey guys, today I will be talking about my favorite topic, search engine optimization. I love free things, and what I love the most is free traffic, and through SEO it is possible. So let's start with the video. Hey guys, welcome back to the Digital Marketing Mastery course. In the last video we talked about how to start your blog and how to configure your WordPress. Today is my favorite topic, search engine optimization. So let's get started. So what is SEO? SEO stands for search engine optimization. It is the process of getting traffic from search results on search engines. So I won't give you this bookish definition, rather show it to you through an example. So if you go to google.co.in and search for the keyword list of free job posting sites in India, the first result is an article on my website, ankuraggarwal.in, free job posting sites in India. So if you click on this result and come onto my website, then you will become a part of organic traffic to my website. So now let's talk about why SEO is even important and why should you even consider doing it for your website. Personally, I love SEO. Why? Because it is free evergreen traffic. So let me show you the stats of various websites that I own on my website for 1 month combined. As you can see that almost 89% of my traffic is coming from search engines. This is another website of mine, and as you can see that almost 50% of my traffic is coming from organic channel. Now I allot around 2 hours per week on this website and it is generating me around $1,000 to $2,000 per month. This is the reason I love SEO. So whenever we talk about SEO, we primarily focus on Google because Google owns the majority market share in the search engine space. So as you can see the data here that Google owns around 75% of the search engine market and Yahoo comes at second place at 8%. Whenever we will be talking about SEO, we'll be focusing entirely on Google. I should also mention that SEO is for organic search result and SEM is for search engine marketing, that is for paid search results. So the goal through SEO is to get into the top 3 ranking positions of Google search results. So let's say if you are searching for the keyword best places in India, then your target will be to rank your website on the first result here, where Travel Triangle is ranking currently. Why? Because it's human tendency to click on the first couple of results and not go down the search results page. Also, according to the stats here, you can see that the position 1 is getting almost 20% of the clicks for the target keyword. It goes down from there for position 2 around 13%, position 4 around 8%, and for position 10 you are only getting 8% of the clicks. So the ultimate goal is to rank your website for the first position. Now there are two ways to get ranked on the first position. Either you can pay money and buy those keywords or you can go the SEO route. So how the hell even Google rank website, right? So although there are 200 plus factors that Google considers while ranking a web page on their search results, but the primary ones are backlinks, content, user experience and site structure. One of the key metrics that Google considers while ranking a web page is the number of backlinks. So backlinks is all about how many different other websites are linking to your web page that you are trying to rank on Google search results. So let's say if you write an article on best credit card in India and it gets mentioned on 30 different websites with a link back to your article, then that means you have 30 different backlinks to your article. We'll be talking about backlinks in the next video of this video course. Now let's talk about content. Content is king when we talk about SEO. The content should be comprehensive. It should be answering all the questions that a person has while searching for the keyword. Let's say if I'm searching for best credit card in India and I click on the first result, if that article can give me all the details, the best credit card, comparison, tables, recommendation, pros and cons, then obviously that's a high quality article. I'll be spending more time on the website. Let me give you another example. So if you search for best places in India and you click on the first result, you'll go to this article of Travel Triangle. As you can see, this article is highly comprehensive. It is covering all the places while adding images. It is also giving bullet points. How to reach, best time to travel, attractions. So you get all the information in one article itself. So you are more likely to share the article, you are more likely to spend time on this article. So that's the kind of article that you have to write in order to get yourself ranked in the first place of Google search result. When we talk about site structure, then factors like speed of your website, the responsiveness of your website, is it loading properly on mobile phone or not? So these are the various factors that affect the ranking of your website. So now let's talk about types of SEO. So there are primarily two types of SEO, on-page SEO and off-page SEO. We will be covering the off-page SEO in the next video. Today we'll be focusing entirely on on-page SEO. Although all of them are equally important. So what is on-page SEO? So these are all the measures, all the tactics that you can use directly within your website in order to improve its position in the search rankings. So there are various factors that affect the on-page SEO. So we'll go through them one by one. So the most important metric is keyword. Keyword in the context of search engine optimization is a particular word or a phrase that describes the content of a web page. So this phrase here, list of free job posting sites in India, is a keyword. As you can see here, Google is also recommending some extra keywords here. Like, people who were searching for this keyword were also searching for all these keywords. My job will be to optimize my article for all these keywords, because the intent is same. In the end, you have to find all the keywords which has similar intent. So here the person is looking for free job posting sites. So you'll have to first find all the keywords where the intent is free job posting sites. Similarly for here, like best places in India. So Travel Triangle is here ranking for best places in India. We do comprehensive keyword research through various paid tools. The one that I personally use and prefer is Ahrefs. So I've already added the URL here of the Travel Triangle article. And as you can see that this article is ranking for almost 2,652 keywords. Look at the keywords here. They all have similar intent. Best places to visit in India, places to visit in India, tourist places in India. So why are keywords even important? Keywords are actually the foundation of your website content. Before I write an article, I spend almost 30 to 50 minutes finding the right keywords. Also, you have to understand that Google is a machine. They have crawlers to understand the content of your website. There is no human eye looking at your content. So the only way they can understand the content of your website is through keywords. So the better optimized your article is for these various keywords, the better ranking you will get in the search results. I've even seen website drive almost 1 million+ visitors to their site without even doing anything else apart from keyword research, because the competition is very low in some of the niches. Whenever we are talking about on-page SEO, it starts with keyword research. So now I hope that you might have understood that keywords are extremely important for your website. So where the hell would you even find these keywords, right? Although there are many free tools also available out there in the market which can be used to do the keyword research, but if you're really serious about SEO, if you are really serious about driving that free organic traffic through Google search results, then you should definitely invest in a paid tool. The one that I personally use and prefer is Ahrefs. So I have a portfolio of almost 10+ websites right now, and all my SEO efforts are done through Ahrefs. Ahrefs is not only used for keyword research, but much more than that. So let me show you the process that I use to do the keyword research. This might differ from what other experts say, but this has been the most profitable one for me. So let's say if I have to write an article on best credit cards in India. What I'll do is I'll first search for the main keywords, the natural looking keyword, the best credit cards in India. Then I'll copy the URL structure of the first article that is ranking, open Site Explorer of Ahrefs, enter the URL here, select prefix and press search. Apart from Ahrefs, you can use other tools like SEMrush. It is also very popular in the market. It also has a comprehensive database for various keywords and the backlinks. So this is my go-to software if I'm not using Ahrefs. It also offers a 30-day trial. I'll make sure I'll add a link there below this video for you to sign up for a 30-day trial. For Ahrefs, you have to pay $7 for the 7-day trial. So that is something you can also do if you want to try the software. You can also use Moz. It's one of the biggest website when we talk about internet marketing online. They also have a SEO software. Apart from that, you can also use this free tool Keyword Finder. Their keyword difficulty metric is really preferred all over the internet. So 26 out of 100 means that this keyword will be fairly difficult to rank, but not too difficult. Also, it gives you a list of all the related keywords like tourist places in India, best tourist places in India, along with the search volume and the CPC. But the keyword difficulty metric here is extremely important. So what all should you remember while doing the on-page SEO? The most important metric is the niche. Your niche should be not too competitive. It should be easy to rank. So whenever you're writing an article, make sure you do comprehensive research. Research is very important before writing any article. So make sure you research your article. Make a list of all the important relevant topics related to your niche, related to the niche of your article. And then do the keyword research. The more keywords you have, the more keywords you are targeting in your article, the better ranking you will get, the more traffic you will get in the future. So let's say if you're writing an article on best credit cards in India. So other related search term is how to apply credit card tips. So these are all related search terms which also have comparable search volume. So you should be incorporating all these keywords in your article. You also have long tail keywords like which credit card is best in India. So this is a long tail keyword. And in the end, you should follow my technique of just putting in the URL of the top ranking articles into Ahrefs and then downloading the Excel sheet of the various keywords. So let's say if you enter 3 different URLs and download 3 different Excel sheets, so make a combined master file and remove the duplicates. The various keyword metrics that you have to look at is the search volume. How many people are actually searching for this keyword in a particular month? Then you have to look at the number of clicks. All this data is available in Ahrefs. So let's say if you are searching for best credit cards in India, then someone might be bidding for the keywords for the paid ads on Google. So if someone is bidding for the keywords, then the number of clicks to your article, even if you're ranking on first position, will be comparatively less. Traffic potential is the cumulative traffic that you can drive to your article for your target keyword. So if someone is searching for best credit card in India, other person might be searching for top credit card in India. Both of them have same intent. So you'll be combining all this traffic to get your traffic potential for your article if you're ranking number one for all these keywords. And the fourth and the most important metric is keyword difficulty. So writing the article is not your job done. You also have to do a lot of things after you write the article. But yes, on-page SEO will make a difference in your rankings. So you have to optimize your article in all the areas, on-page SEO and off-page SEO as well, in order to rank to the number one position. I've already showed you Ahrefs on how to use it in finding the right keywords. Apart from that, I've already shown you SEMrush and Keyword Finder. These are the two different tools apart from Ahrefs that you can use to do your keyword research. Finally, I'll give you a list of all the other different metrics that are equally important for your on-page SEO. First is the website speed. A fast loading website is highly preferred by Google, so make sure you do all the optimizations to increase the loading speed of your website. So how do you even find the loading speed? So let me give you an example. So open this page, Pingdom website speed test, and I've taken this dummy website, Online Media Master. Why? Because they have already optimized their website for speed. So as you can see, their website loads in 708 milliseconds. This is exceptionally good results. Even my websites are taking almost 2.5 seconds to load. This is another tool that you can use to check the speed of your website. Apart from Pingdom, GT Metrics is also highly considered by the online marketing experts. Here you can see again that the website takes a 100% score in page speed score and almost 97% in YSLOW score. And again here it is only loading in 0.8 seconds. Right now I'm feeling jealous because even I want my websites to load as fast as this guy. And here the best part is both of these tools will also give you recommendations on how and where you can improve to increase the speed of your website. So all you have to do is click on these arrow and they'll give you all the URLs which might be causing the issues and all the various metrics where you're scoring and your score as well. Now let's talk about dwell time. Dwell time is the time that a person on average spends on your article after coming from the Google search results. Let's take the same example of best places in India. If you'll go to traveltriangle.com article, the article is well formatted. It has bolds, italics. It has all the information for all these places. It has multimedia element and it has bullet points, key attraction. So it is answering almost all of my questions. And the best part is you can even book the place here. So I'm more likely to spend more time here because I'm getting all the information that I'm looking for. So let's say if I'm spending almost 7 minutes on this article and only 3 minutes on the next article, then Google will understand, okay, that the first result is relevant one because the user metric is the best kind of metric. Because if I am loving the article, definitely other people will also love the article. Let's take another scenario here. If majority of the people who are searching for best credit cards in India go to this third result and spend more time on this third result compared to the first and the second results, then Google will think, okay, the third result might be more relevant. Why? Because people are clicking more on the third result and also spending more time on the article. Hence, Google might promote this article to the first position. That is not the only metric, but yes, this will also help in getting better ranking in the Google search results. I still remember one of my own example. There was this article which I ranked from number 5 to number 1 position just by increasing the length of my article, by adding more multimedia content, by making use of simple language. And just because of that, the on article time on an average was increased and hence Google promoted my website to the number 1 position. Now let's talk about internal links. So let's say if you write an article about best credit card in India, you already have articles on how to improve your credit card score. Putting a link to this new article in these already existing article will also help increase the ranking of your website. So if you have purchased a theme online, then responsive design is something that you don't have to worry about because majority of the new themes are responsive in nature. So your website should be customized for a tablet, for a mobile phone, for a laptop, etc. So if you're buying a theme online, this problem will already be covered. Meta title and description. This is another very important metric that you have to take care of. So what do we mean by meta title and meta description? Here this line 11 best credit cards in India 2018 review is the meta title. And here this extra text below along with the date is the meta description. So all of this is available in the backend while you're writing the article in WordPress. From there you can customize it. But the ultimate goal of meta title and description is it should have the target keyword. As you can see, the first result which is ranking, it has the target keyword best credit cards in India. So Google is more likely to rank it because Google understands that this article is relevant to the person who is searching for that query. Also, as you can see here, that the URL structure also has the main keyword cashoverflow.in/best credit cards in India. So having the main keyword in your URL also helps a lot in the search engine ranking. So this was it about the meta title and description. So here I will end this on-page SEO section, and thanks for watching this.
Now you have the exact blueprint on how to optimize your articles for search engines. In the next video, we talk about the other very important aspect of SEO, that is backlinks. Writing an article is not enough. You also need to build backlinks to get it ranked on the search results. So tomorrow, I'll share you my strategies that I use to get my articles ranked. Till then, write your first blog post and share it on our Facebook group, and we'll give you the feedback.